Hello everyone, and welcome back to Life is Strange. Last time we got to the end of episode 3. So now we are going to start episode 4. Let's play some games.
In the previous episodes of Life is Strange.
Whoa! Called film Little Pieces of Time.
Because Max wants everybody to see.
I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
And there she is.
How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories.
Let's talk about your superpower.
Hey, Stelman Louise, you're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please, step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Please, get me out of here! Max!
Nobody cares about me. Nobody. What are you doing here, Max?
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the route with Kate Marsh? Please, tell us everything.
What the hell is this?
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today.
I believe you, Warren. I'll believe anything this week.
So, things are just getting worse and worse and worse, but we saved Kate, and that's a huge step forward to good things. Beautiful moon that's not being eclipsed. We'll get taller. Oh, that's the different building. That's not the building that Kate tried to jump off of. Moths. Did you know that moths are not attracted to light, but they're attracted to the darkest point, which is right behind the brightest light? I don't know if that's true. I just heard that once. Doesn't make a lot of sense, but maybe it's true. Wait, are we only on episode 3? We are only on episode 3. Oh, we have Kate's bunny. Though. I have something to show you. Meet me in front of campus. Get dad ass in gear now.
I knew Chloe would be all over this, so I better get moving.
There's so many pages. Yeah, oh my god, we have so much shit. I don't know where we left off. I don't know where we left off, and I'm getting kind of sick of reading those. All right, 2 from Warren. Hey girl. Sit down, science brah. I'm in the sci-fi lab now, but I'm no Schrodinger's kitty. See you soon. Yo-Yo, Max, I just have to remind you how fucking awesome you were today with Kate on the roof. I'll make you a superhero suit with the lab's 3D printer, cool? And I'd love to reward you with dinner and escape to a planet of apes. No pressure. Truly. Thanks, Warren. I need to rest my cape tonight, especially since I got Mr. Jefferson kicked out of his own contest. I'll call you later, okay? Go away, Warren. Thanks for letting me gush all over Blackwell Hero. So, wait. Oh, yeah, it is. Okay. Max, please call us as soon as you can. We are so proud of you for saving that girl. We want to know how you are, so please, please get in touch. We love you. Sorry, Mom. I'll call you back in a few minutes. Swear. Thanks for letting me gush over our Blackwell Hero. I miss your voice. We're very proud, so milk this moment. Let us know if you want to come up... let us know if you want to come up for a quick getaway, okay? We love you, Maxine. We're very proud of you, so milk this moment. Yes, milk this poor girl's attempted suicide. That's a fine idea. Max, I wish you had popped a cap in Frank's ass instead of giving him the gun. No, Chloe, I do not wish that, and neither do you. Is it too late to rewind? Sorry about Kate. Hope you're okay. This eclipse freaks me out. Let's find out what's going on. Together. Yo, Super Max, how's the Blackwell Hero doing? The hero is still shaking with nerves. You're a boss, but no emoji! I also got my favorite teacher suspended. Yay me. Dude, you so own that school. Listen, something weird and scary is going on at Blackwell. It's time for us to put the pieces together. Cool? I have something to show you. Meet me in front of campus. Get dead ass in gear now. It's almost midnight, Jesus.
Hey, Bunny. Kate will be back soon, and until then, I'll be catering to your every whim.
Feed the bunny.
Are you hungry, Bunny? Here, nosh on this.
What about the pictures? Alright, trophy, squirrels, fish. Alright, let's go. Wow, it's super creepy.
Okay, this is scary dark. Let there be...
Wherever you go, there I am.
So much hypocrite.
I don't think that was grammatically correct. All well-wishers.
Do they really need that crap on the door? Kate's still alive.
Dana is not in her room. Yes, she is. Sorry.
Hey, Dana. How are you doing?
Better than Kate. I just can't believe she would even attempt suicide.
We're all responsible. Yes, she was depressed, and yes, it was Victoria's fault, but we are all responsible.
I think we're all responsible for what happened.
True. But you're the only one who went up to that roof with Kate.
I was lucky.
I was lucky. That's all.
No, girl. That was not luck. You made a choice to save her. Like a superhero.
Then maybe it's time to catch the bad guys.
So what exactly are you saying, Max? I know Jefferson got reamed by the principal. Do you think they're involved?
It's complicated.
It's complicated. I don't want to drag you into this, okay? Not yet, anyway.
I'm getting scared now. But people here are still sneaking out tonight.
What? Like, who?
Victoria bounced out of here earlier, and now you, Sherlock?
Not me. I need a break from today. Get some sleep too, Dana. I'll see you later.
I learned something.
I am wiped out, Max. We'll talk later.
Oh, Victoria isn't here. Maybe I'll just wait and bide my time. Going through her shit.
Yep, that sounds like a good thing. Ooh.
Since I've crossed the line from snoop to detective, I might as well search for clues about what really happened to Kate at the Vortex Club party.
That looks just like... Oh, yeah, here we go. That's pretty cool. I love glow-in-the-dark shit. Alright, so squirrels and fireflies, fish, cigarette bird. Squirrels will be the next one, though, so that'll probably be outside.
I'll title this one, Portrait de la Assholes. Whoa, there's Kate. Totally high. She looks confused. Not like she's partying.
Yeah, that's sus.
These socks cost more than my wardrobe.
Well, socks are pretty cheap.
Victoria is about as street as me. But she really appreciates style.
I bet we gotta go through her laptop. Ooh, trash can.
That's a lot of bank just to clean paint from a sweater.
$30? Ugh.
Victoria's secret. She's a geek.
Glow-in-the-dark blueberry.
Well, well. Victoria and Taylor actually show remorse.
Hey, sweet tea, what's up? I'm just avoiding some lame-ass science homework. How anyone can do fucking homework after someone almost jumps off a roof? I can't believe we all saw it live. It was like watching a reality show. I've never seen the campus so quiet, like everyone's afraid or hiding. Yes, I feel like total shit for everything I said about Kate in that stupid video. Let's get some peeps to meet up later. This girl needs some serious curfew cocktail. We'll drink to Kate. From Taylor. What a trip today. Seeing Max and Kate like that? I need a drink too. Let me know the time. XO, sweet tea. So what am I in here looking for exactly?
Here they are getting loaded with Satan.
Getting loaded with Satan. A sticker?
First Rachel and now Kate? This is the end of the Vortex Club.
Oh, search.
A unique point of view is right. Thanks to Courtney Wagner ghostwriting this paper.
Alright, I have no idea what I'm searching for. Shoes.
Those boots are made for walking runways.
Max was saying something and I fucking forgot it. I didn't even see it. I still have to meet up with Chloe. Bathroom's open. Someone in here? Taylor's in here.
Hey, Max. I saw you go up on the roof and save Kate. I can't believe she tried to jump.
Ah, there it is.
I know. Victoria must be upset since I saw her sneaking out of the dorm past curfew.
Oh, man. Like, you saw her? She was so, like, nervous when she left the dorm. She wouldn't even tell me where she was going.
Probably to hell.
Oh.
Well, I have to go crash. It's been a rough day, as you know.
Thanks, Max. And it was, like, pretty awesome when you went up to the roof to save Kate. Victoria was wrong about you. Now I have to be alone for my nightly anxiety attack. Talk to you later.
Oh, Taylor.
I, like, really do need to get some sleep, Max.
All right. Bye, Taylor. Honey, this is gonna drain the hell out of your battery. I see fireflies, now all I need to see are squirrels.
So Chloe is waiting for me in front of the main hall.
Nope, don't sit. Oh, is that a squirrel? Yeah, that's a squirrel. Come back here, squirrel. Oh, photo.
Look at the lens and say nut. Gotcha.
I'm getting quite the squirrel portfolio, aren't I? Alright, so next is fish. Totem.
The Tabanka does look pretty scary at night. Please don't destroy me. Maybe Samuel should fix that lamp.
Samuel has enough to deal with. Alright.
Principal Wells. Oh, are you serious? I'm toast if he sees me.
Nobody can expect.
Max?
Tell me. Not yet, anyway.
He's lucky nobody else saw him like that. Except me.
He's fucking wasted.
Max the Ninja strikes again. He's lucky nobody else saw him like that. Except me.
The hell is he doing? Where is Chloe?
Booyah!
Ah!
Get it? Booyah. Like I'm a scary punk ghost.
It scared me.
More like a scary punk asshole. Hey, Chloe, I didn't exactly have the greatest day trying to keep my friend from jumping off the roof. I don't think I need you to prank me tonight, okay?
Sorry, but you absolutely balls to the walls did save your friend.
Kate saved herself. I couldn't even use my power. My head felt like it was being crushed. And then I had no clue what to say to her on that roof.
Don't be so modest, Rockstar. Kate is alive because of you. You obviously said the right thing, and your badass power is gonna save us all. We just need to connect the plays.
And find out who almost killed Kate. We have to stop this from happening to anybody else.
Oh yeah, and somehow stop that tornado from wiping out Arcadia Bay, right?
I hope so.
I hope so, Chloe. But how? Snow and Eclipse are bad omens.
This whole town is a bad omen. I noticed that Blackwell seems to be ground zero.
Chloe, I just feel weird about some of my decisions. Especially after I just got Mr. Jefferson in trouble.
Dude, do not even torture yourself like that. Let's focus on looking for clues, okay?
About, Chloe is more interested in Rachel.
We need to find out more about who Rachel was involved with around here.
She was able to blend in with everybody, even with people I hated.
And even though I don't know her, it feels like Rachel is guiding us to the truth.
Fuck the truth. I just want to find my friend right now. It scares me to think where she could be. Do you think she's...
kicking it.
Kicking it in Los Angeles? That would be the best case scenario.
She wouldn't leave without me, okay? And how often do missing girls turn up? We have to find Rachel soon. We have to.
I promise you we will. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues. Now tell me what's your secret.
Drumroll, please. I present the spare keys to Blackwell. Thank you, step prick.
You are such a boss, Chloe. I just don't want you to get into any more trouble.
Look at all the trouble dropping in Arcadia Bay. At this point, who gives a fuck anymore? We're in it to win it, Max. Lead the way.
I'm so glad you're my partner in crime.
As long as you're my partner in time.
Insert groan here.
Chloe, she's been gone for 6 months.
Thank you so much for helping me put together a portfolio.
Hopefully the rest of the class will follow your lead. I'm sorry I was distracted. As you know, it's not been a good day for Blackwell.
I know this has been an awful day, and you can talk to me anytime, Mr. Jefferson.
Thank you, Victoria. I'm glad it had a relatively happy ending.
I don't know what I would have done if Katie jumped.
Katie? I had no idea you two were that close. Did she?
Well, how does this affect the Everyday Heroes contest?
The contest will go on. I just won't be representing Blackwell at the event this year, thanks to Max, who claims I enabled Kate Marsh's trouble by merely listening to her.
I'll give you a one-word sneak preview of Max's photo. Selfie. Listen, you've seen my entry. You know it's better than that. Wouldn't that be so cool to hang out together in San Francisco, Mark?
Whoa.
Stick to Mr. Jefferson, Victoria. I won't be going to San Francisco, remember?
You already love my work, so it's not like you're playing favorites. Just imagine if you picked my photo, though. We would have to spend a lot of time together.
Whoa.
That could be fun, don't you think?
Whoa.
I'm going to think that you didn't say any of that.
You might as well choose me. Otherwise, I might have to tell people you offered to choose my photo for favors.
Whoa.
Or something.
As a favor to your future, I'll also ignore that undisguised threat. This conversation is officially over, Miss Chase. I suggest you go back to your dorm now.
Wait! I only
tried to whore myself out to you to win a contest. Salat.
So stupid. Just when I think Victoria can't get any more evil, shit is about to get real at Blackwell.
Ew.
Let's go find out.
Just this whole thing is ew. That's gross as hell.
Chloe the Keymaster. You know it. Dude, I don't know about this. We're both already in so much trouble. Not to mention the weed you brought into my room.
Joking.
I'm serious. We're not kids anymore. We're breaking and entering. If I have a key, how can it be breaking? I get charges for just entering.
That's called trespassing.
We could go to jail. Not if I'm related to the head of Blackwell Security. Stepshit will not want me in the hands of the local police. So we better find out what's in the principal's office first. You can rewind if we get caught, right? You have mad powers, Max.
But my powers didn't save Kate. Maybe I did on my own.
Come on. One more door and our work here is done.
I'm not ready. I want to explore because we got some photos to find. Can't go in the bathroom. We've got photos to find. We're looking for fish and some kind of smoking kills thing. And that looks like a bird on a stand. Oh, can go in here. Ooh, exam file.
An A minus? All right. So Dr. Max did help Warren this morning.
No, we will not. I see fish.
I never said they were great, troll.
Wow.
Everybody's asleep. I hate to wake them up, but I want a picture.
Yeah, I want
Good
a picture
evening,
too.
Fish.
You know, fish don't really sleep, so.
Thanks, fish. Nice work.
Now we're looking for some kind of smoking kills. Turn that
Please
off.
Please resume your slumber.
Oh, that's funny. That's really funny. I like that. So now we're looking for some kind of bird on a stand. wonder if Miss Grant did that or if one of the students did that, because that's funny. I like that a lot. Max's battery would be so dead, and her phone would be so hot right now. At least my phone would be.
Oh, Kate. Even when you were sad, you tried to see the good in the world. Shit. Daniel's a better illustrator than photographer, said Max, the art critic. Victoria, that is pretty fucking sweet. How can I hate somebody that shoots like that?
Because she's a terrible human?
I say one stupid thing and Mr. Jefferson gets screwed. Nice going, Max.
Well, we saw the other options. Sorry, Mr. Jefferson, but it's a dog-eat-dog world. Dear Mark, I just wanted to drop you an informal note to let you know that Blackwell is conducting an investigation into the events of this week. You'll be receiving an official notice in the mail, but you deserve to be told about this now. I respect your work and status here at Blackwell, and I hope you won't think too harsh of me in this very difficult time. I hope this all works out in your favor, Raymond Wells. May the odds be ever in your favor.
Victoria's cigarettes? I'm sure Mr. Jefferson is impressed.
Why does everybody smoke? I mean, maybe my clique at school wasn't into that sort of thing, but to my recollection, a lot of the high schoolers in my area did not smoke when I was in high school. But again, maybe that was just my clique that didn't smoke, because I was the anime club Dungeons and Dragons clique. We didn't do anything bad, ever, except be nerds. Alright, let's go to Chloe.
Only a total phony would wear a crappy hat like that.
Hey, look, keys.
That's it. What the fuck? The security officer should have the key to the principal's office.
He's hiding shit, like everybody here.
Well, now we definitely have to get this door open. Believe it or not, I know a little about lockpicking, thanks to Frank. I might as well test out my thief skill.
Go for it. We're already in this deep.
Well, you could look for the key, just in case.
Why, yes, I could.
Gee, I wonder if the key is on this wall of keys.
Here are the keys. None for the principal's office.
God damn it. Drawer?
Crap. Dead end. Boring.
Last one.
Nothing here.
Shit.
No key for thee. We have to find another way in.
Guess I didn't spend enough time with Frank, but I'll use my DIY lockpick tools while you come up with a better plan.
My plan has a name. Hey, Warren, you busy? Just bubble hearth, you'll be okay. Listen, I need your physics expertise stat. Without naming names, if somebody had access to the art and science labs and wanted to construct a device that would, say, open a locked door, would you maybe kinda know how? Huh? No, I'm just asking for fun. Thanks, science guy. No, stay. We need you as backup. Just send the text instructions now. I'm sorry, I'm just not sure about a movie night right now. Don't hate me, and thanks for the help.
This sucks ass. Goddamn door.
Try not to wake up everybody at Blackwell.
Sorry, Max. I got nothing. What about your plan?
I'm gonna go put it together. Can you stay here and not get caught?
I might get on the other side of that door before you, Lupin.
The race is on. See you soon.
Pay attention, 007. You have to find four objects. Sugar, a soda can, duct tape, and sodium chlorate. That sounds not like physics, but chemistry. Here's how you'll do it. Any questions? Yep. Sodium chlor, what the fuck? It's a powder you use to create chlorine dioxide. Shit, everybody knows that. So are you really gonna try this? Keyword is try. I bow to your wisdom. Yep, we are in fact making a bomb. That is chemistry.
Warren is such a classic nerd.
Not physics.
Let's see if I can find those items.
Trash can.
No can here. Gross. Empty. Come on.
Well, they should be emptying the trash cans every night, so...
Nothing. This is so lame.
Ah, can.
Okay, I have the can.
Got a can.
Only three more items to go.
Oh, weed killer?
Here's the sodium chloride box.
Can I take it?
You know you're clumsy, Max. Don't waste your rewind power. Use the damn chair.
She's learning.
You're halfway home, Max.
You still there? Did you blow up? Max? Still here. Didn't blow up. Not yet. Need to concentrate now. Talk to you later. Fuck off. So, now what else do we need? Not the graffiti. We won't need that. Sugar.
Ooh, sugar. Only one more ingredient left.
And it must be in the art room, or else they wouldn't have asked about it, or it would be locked. So, what is the last one? Nope, that's not a door. This is the door.
This is like a scene in a horror film.
I mean, yes. Duct tape.
The tape is mine. Now it's time to show Chloe that Max is the bomb.
Let's check the photos first before we move on. Nope. We're looking for a bird on a stand. I have not seen anything that looks like that, so we'll just move on. There's a way out. Jog briskly back before Chloe beats us. Pipe bomb.
Take it easy on the door, Chloe. Let's try this instead. Boom! Literally. Yes! Time to blow shit up! If you'll light the candle. This is so cool! Get ready to haul ass.
This is a good idea.
That was so fucking cool! Oh, we are toast! Here comes the whole Arcadia Bay Fire and Police Department. So what should we do?
We're just gonna pretend that this never happened. That's what we're gonna do.
If I can get this bastard open, she can't cheat with her rewind. Oh, this is bullshit! Fuck you, door.
Welcome to my domain.
You are magic! I have no clue how the hell you got in there, but you did it, sister.
The company I keep. Now, let's find what we want and beat it. My powers only go so far.
Man, I can see why the principal locks this room up. Fancy faux art crap. He must want everybody to know he has money, but no taste. How can you trust somebody who has a fucking bronze bird in his office? I'm glad I was expelled.
Yes, if only the principal had a Monet or Picasso, you'd still be at Blackwell.
Eat me. I'm gonna pilfer the papers on this ugly-ass desk.
I found the bird.
Okay, sure. It's ugly, but damn, is it a cozy chair.
This is your chance to truly get all deductive and shit, Sherlock. Find us some clues about Rachel, or Kate, or Nathan. Anybody.
I'm on the case.
First, let's get that bronze bird. Oh, there it is.
Chloe, say hello to my little friend.
Say goodnight to the bad guy.
Aww. Orin. Did you blow up the lock, Unabomber? Oh, please, I just wanted to see if you know your explosives and to see your incredible artwork. Gross.
You're not so tacky up close.
It's still kind of tacky.
That is so cool that my signature actually counted. Go, Miss Grant.
Okay. Sorry about that. Dear Miss Grant, as principal of Blackwell Academy, it is my glad, happy, fortunate duty to inform you that your petition to block the installation of the new surveillance system has received enough signatures for the school to reject the plan. It is not my policy to take sides in these matters, as we encourage the faculty of the student and student body to participate in their school's operation. However, I did recognize the controversial nature of these cameras and shared your concern for possible invasions of privacy. Thank you for your passion and for inspiring Blackwell students to make their voices heard. I hope they will feel empowered as you I hope they will feel empowered by the outcome of your petition. Best, Principal Wells. Files.
I guess being a bully is in the Prescott DNA.
Principal Wells, it has come to my attention that the Prescott family crest has been removed from the library wall for no apparent reason. This local historical quest is required as per the donation terms of the library, or the donation will be rescinded, among others, for the school. Along with that, I understand that the tragic event involving Miss Marsh gives you pause, but I will suggest thus canceling Thursday's party is not conducive to the can-do spirit of Blackwell Academy. I expect you to reconsider and come to the same obvious conclusion. Thank you, Sean Prescott. Well, you know, if it was part of the deal, I will fund your school if you leave this crest up, and then you take the crest down. That's a perfectly valid reason to rescind your donation.
Tumbleweeds. Weird. This asshole has a spotless record.
Student information sheet, Nathan Joshua Prescott, GPA 3.7. Nathan Prescott continues his family's historical legacy at Blackwell Academy with a stellar academic record and a variety of extracurricular activities, including work with the Arcadia Bay Homeless Fund. Nathan is also popular with students and faculty. He stands as a proud representation of Blackwell. Ooh!
Like I'm not gonna read my own personal file.
Maxine Caulfield, GPA 2.8. Max. Brief summary. Max, as she prefers to be called, is considered a quiet, attentive student with much potential for her photography. Her GPA fluctuates, but she has acknowledged that she should be doing better. Her teachers back up her quiet intelligence, so some complaints find her too nervous and nosy. Some faculty members would like Max to speak up more in class and be more assertive. Others would like her to be less so. But this is a common student suggestion rather than a specific recommendation. Update. Despite some recent confrontations with Blackwell security, Max has shown herself to represent the very best of Blackwell Academy, as she stopped fellow student Kate Marsh from jumping off the dormitory roof today. At this time, there is an ongoing police faculty investigation, but Max's heroism is undisputed.
This file is going to be so spotless, I'll projectile vomit.
Victoria Maribeth Chase, GPA 3.9, that's pretty good. Victoria Chase is the gold standard for Blackwell Academy, a student with a consistently high GPA and extracurricular activities that reflect her career goals in photography. Victoria also receives high marks from faculty for her devotion to the Vortex Club, among other organizations devoted to Blackwell's spirit and history.
I have to make sure Warren doesn't have a criminal background.
Warren Graham? 4.0. Nice. Warren is considered an exemplary student and represents a long tradition of excellence in science at Blackwell. He has the gift, of course, of gab, depending on the faculty. Some have accused him of playing science pranks, but this is not confirmed by his science teacher, Miss Grant. We hope Warren focuses his academic vision and continue towards his bright future. Without Max involved.
Only two more files to go. Look at this pile.
Yeah, I want you to.
Looks like an oil painting spill. Awful.
Kate's file.
This pretty much sums up Kate. Shy and sweet. And in the wrong place.
Kate Beverly Marsh, 3.9? Kate Marsh represents the very best of the students at Blackwell Academy. Her GPA is consistently outstanding, along with her optimistic attitude and quiet work ethic. Her extracurricular activities with the Meals on Wheels program has been acknowledged in the KBAY News, 7 News. And her diverse religious studies group has been a welcome addition to the wide range of student-led spiritual programs at Blackwell. She also has one of the best attendance records in the school's history. Principal Wells, as a school nurse, I should inform you that Kate Marsh appears to have experienced some recent emotional or physical trauma. I spoke to her briefly, and she was upset but vague and refused to talk further with me. I think it's important that we keep our eyes on her and make sure she's not under duress from the other classmates, as is my suspicion. Regards, Anne-Marie Berenci. Update. At present time, there is a security investigation into the controversial video allegedly featuring Kate Marsh at a Vortex Club party that has been uploaded onto the internet without her knowledge or alleged consent, along with her claim of being taken to the hospital during the party. See attached files for complete details.
Let's nab this last file, Sherlock. Always wanted to say nab. I certainly can't use this.
Okay, then why is it highlighted?
Wowzer, this will so not come in handy. I'd drink too if I was the principal of Blackwell. And nothing here. Rachel doesn't seem so troubled based on all this. But there's not much here about the police investigation.
Rachel Dawn Amber. Wow, that's like 3 stripper names. Update. Unfortunately, Rachel Amber has stopped attending class for the past month, and she's left no contact with students or faculty for the past month. Her parents are at present unaware of her whereabouts, and Blackwell hopes for her quick return to continue her academic excellence. Brief summary, Rachel Amber is a quintessential student representation of Blackwell Academy. She excels in all of her studies and extracurricular activities, which are numerous. Popular with both students and faculty, she has the de facto qualities of scholarship and leadership that is the hallmark of Blackwell's legacy. Her diverse goals include a career in international law and fashion modeling. There is no doubt that Rachel will achieve all of her dreams with Blackwell as the fulcrum. Principal Wells, this is Lieutenant Chris Rossi. Just wanted to let you know that Rachel Amber's investigation has officially been closed on our end. We always hope for that one magic clue, but once again, Arcadia Bay covers up another secret. We always have our eyes and ears open, but that's all we can do for now. Thanks for all your help. Lieutenant Chris Rossi, Arcadia Bay, PD.
Man, I don't blame the principal for expelling Chloe. Bad Chloe.
Chloe Elizabeth Price, GPA 1.7. Chloe Price is a problematic student at Blackwell, despite the best efforts of the faculty and the administration to guide her academically. Chloe does little homework and is often willingly belligerent to her teachers. She's caused numerous class disruptions with inappropriate comments and rude gestures to fellow students. She was recently suspended for spray painting graffiti in the parking lot. Even though Chloe is an intelligent student with potential, she chooses to squander it on empty rebellion against a non-mandatory institution. Update, Chloe Price is no longer a student at Blackwell. See attached police reports. Chloe.
I think we found everything in here. I should go join Chloe now.
Max, you better come check out these files. Nathan accuses Rachel of bringing drugs on campus, and my step-troll went along because he thinks Rachel was a bad influence on me. Assholes.
If David is teaming up with Nathan Prescott, that's a bad sign.
Nathan Prescott III. Ooh, he's so money. And you know the Prescotts dropped Major Bank to bury Nathan's real file. Look, it reads like a rap sheet. Bad grades, teacher complaints, secret probation. But I was expelled?
The Prescotts always get their money's worth. Check out that note. Open it.
It's just some crazy drawing.
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
That's fucked up. What does this even mean? Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Whoa, listen to this. David M. always asks what's going on in my head. David M. always helps me follow those he follows. It's pretty cryptic.
No, it sounds like they formed some sort of weird team, the Super Hebros.
Jesus. David was stalking Kate, hassling me, and now we know he was all over Rachel, too.
Oh, we are so going into his garage files. Plus, I'm getting a little paranoid in here. We got our info. Let's bail. But maybe we shouldn't leave without a gift.
No, you are not taking the cozy chair.
Max, do your powers include mind reading? Or did you just rewind because I tried to steal the chair? Shit, I'm confused.
It's the powers of best friendship. I know how you roll. We should definitely get out of here. We pressed our luck enough.
Hello, what have we here? Holy shit! Jackpot! Cha-ching!
Wowzer. That's a lot for the handicapped fund.
Dude, there's $5,000 here. I could pay Frank back tonight. This'll chill him out after our knife showdown yesterday. Are you gonna make a big issue out of this? Or just rewind and take the greenbacks for yourself? I hope you do that instead of lecturing me.
From everything I know about Principal Wells, I kind of doubt that it's actually for the handicap fund. I really do.
Frank knows things about Rachel, and he might talk if he's been paid, right?
You are Supermax. And with the leftover dough, I'll take you on a road trip to Portland for the day. We'll stock up on tats, beer, weed, and donuts, and books from Powell's, and strip clubs. Kidding. But you never know.
I feel like shit for taking that money.
Yeah, but Chloe needs help. And it's probably not actually for the handicap fund.
That impish look scares me.
Care for a midnight swim? The Blackwell pool is ours.
Swimming? You want to take that risk now?
It's been a cray week. We deserve a little mindless fun in the water. We're done for the night anyway. We're rich, and nobody busted us. So? Splish splash?
You're right. We hella deserve it. Splish splash.
Did you actually just say hella? I think I'm a good bad influence on you. Fucking deal. I want that heated water.
Ooh, it's heated.
We still have to play it cool, okay? I still go to school here.
You can own this hellhole once you figure out your rewind power.
Chloe is so psyched for girls' night out, so I better follow her evil plan.
All right, we are going to stop it right here. So, I've been Rael. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!